organ or some chakra. So this way the various types of meditation comes. Chakra meditation will come, then organ meditations come, then pyramid meditation, sun meditation, n number of ways. Because what he has said is that selection of an object is important. Whatever it is not a matter. Because once we understand the later on processes, you will understand. The object doesn't stay important in the process of meditation. The process is important. So initially, defining what is the object, defining the boundaries of the object. And while defining the boundaries, defining the object, in that process, because see, just try to understand and imagine what we are doing. We are sitting still. We are doing pratyahar has already happened. Now we are in a state of dharana. So we are totally in that position of meditation. The process is happening. We have selected an internal or external object. And when we have selected any object, say for instance, any of a deity like Rama we have selected for our meditation purpose. So, what happens when we are focusing upon that particular object, we tend to get many intrusions. When I start my meditation, many of us have a question that there are many disturbances, n number of thoughts, and most of the times ill thoughts come to disturb first. This is a process and it happens in that manner only because it is basically your subconscious drainage. When I am focusing on any particular thing, say for instance I have taken this brain for meditation. There are people who meditated on the brain also, the structure of the brain. They have their own purposes and definitions why to meditate, to get more benefit, more. Many cults and many institutions promote various objects for meditation. So for instance, if I am meditating on my brain, there may be my family which will come in, my patients will come in, some of my enemies, some of my ill thoughts will keep on jumping. You may have already experienced it. Whenever we sit, just we sit for meditation, leave apart what is meditation. But jaise baithe, waise aankh band ki aa gaya koi to. Ek ne jump mare, dusre ne jump mare. Has anyone of you done vipassana? Or any type of meditation? Pura janam se leke abhi tak ke sab yaad aa jate hain. No one is left out. You sit silent and there your friend will jump in. There your enemies, there your foes, friends, everyone will jump in. And they will keep on bringing some or the other thought. Leave apart that. So, even if I am myself, next thought will come. Array, today what is the rate of the shares? Is the BSE going up or down? Oh, my shares, it will fall. Then I will again get disturbed. I will see the paper, see the Sensex, okay. No. Now I can sit stable. Again I will sit. Again the next moment something else will come. So this goes on coming and going. Always the initial stages, there is a lot of disturbance. So this process of dharana. In dharana, we are confining. As we have done in pratyahara also, we have decided upon what is our goal to be reached. We have decided upon that we have to work upon chitta. That we have done in pratyahara. Now in dharana, for working upon chitta, to make it more fine and pure, we are using some other objects. Focus that chitta on that object. Okay? Yeah. Selection of object. Right.
And you like that object or the other thoughts are intelligent thoughts or
tribute. Yeah. Yeah.
Just to minimize that.
Yeah, yeah.
So the object one likes it.
Yeah. Right, right. They have said, as you must have heard about when we do tratak. In tratak, they have mentioned what is the object on which you have to do the tratak. The object can be anything. May it be a flame, may it be any symbol or anything, but it should not create any thought in your mind. you should not have any type of attachment to that object. Then only that object will give you least of the disturbance, as Angal is right over here. So, that selection, when we select that object, we have to think over these things, of course. Huh? So, once we have selected the object, now the process starts happening. Whatever, the best of the object, which will not disturb me, I am sure about it. I sit still and select that object. I am happy with that object. I know that it is a lovable object. But then too, it will keep on coming. It will keep on coming. The process is that way. So first is that subconscious drainage. Everything will, it will just come, and you have to just observe. So learning to observe only one thing, as we do in our usual meditation also, even if you are doing asanas. If you are doing asanas with total concentration, we tell in our institute also, see that you have to learn to do asanas with total consciousness, total awareness. You have to put off your mobile gadgets, that's a different thing. But put off the every other thought also that tries to intrude. If at that particular time some of the news comes or something from my family or something enters into my brain, I just have to keep calm and say, now I am doing asanas. Now I am doing pranayama. So, of course, you are important, but after 1 hour. I will see towards you, but after 1 hour. As I have talked in attitude development, he has already made it clear that vitarka badane pratipaksha bhavanam. Wherever vitarka enters, try to respect that vitarka and keep it aside and learn to focus. And that is what we have learned till now. And now we are reached a state, now we are near to samadhi. But at that time also, even if we have learned everything, even if we have applied everything, then also there is a lot of store in, they say, there is a lot of store. So that store has to get released. So it will get released. Even if you purposefully do it or don't do it purposefully, it has to happen and it happens. So that is the stage of dharana. In that they have explained it like savitarka, nirvitarka, savichara, nirvichara. This is again a big concept, samapattis. So in the stage of dharana, these four types happen. So initially it will be vitarkas will come. All evil thoughts, then all good thoughts, nirvitarka. Then there are some thoughts that are helpful for a yogi, savichara. But still vichara is there, thought is there. And then a state comes where nirvicharka. Evil gaya, good also has to go. Because when I am sitting still, what goes on I will tell you. Baithe ki continuous chalu. Now I have reached a state. Wow, no thought. Commentary will go on continuously. Then someone will come. Again that commentator will be there. Arey, why is this one is disturbing me? Okay, I have put him aside. Now I am silent. Will keep on disturbing you. Ye word chalta hi rahega. Now I am totally silent. Ye thought aate hi rahega. Has anyone experienced this? वो तो बाकी रहेगा ही, बाकी सब कुछ चला जाए, पर वो बाकी रहेगा. हाँ, अभी एकदम मैं शांत हो गया, अभी कुछ नहीं आ रहा. वहाँ कितना अच्छा लग रहा है. ये भी चालू ही रहेगा. So that state where even the mind becomes spellbound, there should be no word left. That comes in the stage of dhyana. In dharana, we are getting all this savichar, nirvichar, savitarka, nirvitarka, savichar, nirvichar, and all this thing. When we come into the state of dhyana, that is tatra pratyak dhyanata dhyanam. As I told you, dharana dhyan samadhi are in one line, one single line processes. Tatra means in dharana. Once in dharana, I do pratyaktanada, means I become so focused on my object. Whatever heaven or hell I have selected, once I get totally focused on that object, I have lost all my storehouse thoughts and I have become totally stable. stability of chitta in dharana is dhyana. Do you understand? Do you understand what I am saying? In dharana, we have selected an object, we are focusing on that object. While focusing on that object, we are getting disturbances. The disturbances are becoming lesser, lesser, lesser.